Welcome to Earl Stewart on Cars.
I bought a brand new Lincoln from Alpacker Lincoln, and then I noticed that there was something wrong with the driver's side door. So I take the car back, and they did accuse me of having the door painted, and God, that never happened. One of the sales managers there told me to come pick up my car. They don't want me as a customer. So I called Lincoln in Dearborn, Michigan, and Lincoln called Alpacker, and I spoke to the secretary because they have people there that take care of it. So finally, after 2 weeks of going back and forth with Lincoln in Dearborn, Michigan, they finally painted it. And the explanation that the service manager gave me, he said that something did happen to the car. They don't know what happened to it. So the point of the story is that they did fix it, and the car is fine. But I must tell you, the way I was treated at Alpacker Lincoln was terrible for that sales department. And nobody has written me a letter saying they're sorry. And I'm just very, very disappointed. You know, I even said to them, you know what? I see commercials with Earl Stewart. He picks up the phone and he talks to his customers. They would not talk to me. They treated me terribly.
Gene, this is Earl. I want to congratulate you for having the courage to call. We ask a lot of people to call about their problems, and for some reason they're a little timid about that. But you just did more to get Al Packer's attention. Of course, Al Packer died many years ago. His son, Mark Packer, runs the dealership.
Mark.
He's probably not very active in the dealership, but it's a pretty bad situation. This radio show reaches tens of thousands of people. A lot of people are going to hear this, and Mark Packer is going to hear it. If he doesn't hear it, we're tweeting it out as we speak. So it's going to reach a lot of people. It'll get back to him, and he'll probably look into it. There should have been a record of that repair, and it would probably be within the internal records of the car dealership. If you ever had to prove it, you could have probably proved it. But they were just trying to stonewall you and hope you'd go away. There's also the fact that, you know, when a car is repainted, it's devalued. And I don't want to make you feel any more unhappy than you already are. But even though that door was painted, and the door was painted well, and when that car is traded in, potentially the resale value of that Lincoln when you trade it in will not be as much as it was had the door never been painted. Every used car department in the country at every dealership has what they call a paint meter, and it's an electronic device that you just rub over the top of the paint, and it measures the thickness of the paint, and they can tell immediately if a car has been repainted. And as you know, if you had bought that Lincoln and known that the door had been repainted, you would have probably said, I'd rather buy another Lincoln that hasn't had the door repainted, even if you couldn't tell. Why would you want to buy a repainted car when you could buy one that had never been repainted, and you'd be wise not to? So bear in mind that if the time comes that you want to go further on this, I think Alpacker owes you some more money. They painted the car. It looks nice now, but it's still a repainted car. It was not disclosed when you bought it, and it should have been. And I'm not sure the exact value depreciation in that Lincoln, but it would probably be at least several hundred dollars, maybe $1,000. It's possible they didn't know, but they should have known. If her son knew, if a non-professional could look at that door and say, hey, it's been painted, then certainly the professionals there that detailed the car, you tell me a good detailer washing a car and going over it doesn't know if a door's been painted, that somebody off the street could spot. So maybe they didn't know, but they sure should have known. It's their responsibility. They should have seen it, and when that was called to her attention, instead of implying that she wrecked the car and right. had it painted, calling Gene a liar, which is it's a terrible thing to do.